viewers at home, wherever you may be, local, international. You see, the entire world is a village now with technology. We're happy to come your way today, and we believe, we strongly believe that you will enjoy the program today. We have brought another edition of your program, Politics and Perspectives on Ifakoijai Television. My name is Samuel Mustafa. I have in the studio my panelists. Let me start with my immediate left. I call him my chairman, Mr. Comrade Samuel Olusola Arowolo. I can't forget your name.
Because
we are namesake, I was just trying to emphasize because you are a chairman of all chairmen.
Hello, viewers.
Okay. And to my immediate right, I have my dear comrade, Comrade Akin Adeyemo. You are welcome to the program.
Thank you very much, sir. I'm happy to be here. And I say hello to all viewers. Thank you for staying tuned.
Okay. And to the extreme right, my extreme right, I have Comrade IT Tuji Ono Olambo. How are you, sir?
Thank you for having me on the program. Viewers, thanks for watching us.
Okay, the topic we have for discussion on the program today is post-Osun gubernatorial primaries, a tale of options and its impacts. Again, post-Osun gubernatorial primaries, a tale of options and its impacts. Before I go on, during the immediate past week, my co-anchor, Comrade Oluwaseun Akintande, lost his mother-in-law, and that's why he's not here on the program today. May the soul of the departed rest in perfect peace, and the family of the departed kindly accept the condolences of all of us at Ifakoijai Television, including our panelists today. Like I said, the topic is post-Osun gubernatorial primaries, a tale of options and its impacts. Let me just quickly make a reference here. Osun State gubernatorial election is coming up on Saturday, September the 22nd this year, that's 2018. And according to INEC guidelines, all political parties wishing to participate in the election are required to submit their candidates, that is the candidate's name, latest by Monday, July the 23rd this year, 2018. Hence, the rush, last minute rush by these political parties to conclude their party primaries, including the appeal process. They must conclude it at this weekend because they have to submit it by Monday. As at the time, as at press time, the following are the major candidates that have emerged. Major. Some of them are not really major, but I'm including them for a particular purpose. So when I say major, I'm concentrating on four political parties. And which of these political parties am I referring to? I'm referring to the People's Democratic Party, PDP, on Saturday, Senator Ademola Adeleke emerged the candidate of PDP by seven votes compared to Kumbi's votes, okay? And as far as APC is concerned, or Progressive Congress, Alhaji Isiaka Gboyega Oyetola is the flag bearer for the party. And SDP, we have two candidates emerging. because they have two parallel primaries. We have Senator Iyola Olusore on one hand and Munirudeen Atunda on the other hand. And ADP, one including ADP, is because Alhaji Adeoti, who contested under APC, is being alleged, is not yet confirmed, that he has decamped to become the ADP gubernatorial candidate in Osun State during the election. But like I said, it is yet to be confirmed. Can we quickly go to opening remarks? Let me start with Aishi Kwame. Are you ready for me?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, can you make your opening remarks very brief, please?
Okay, thank you very much for having me this on this program. Mm-hmm. This is the era of primaries, and it's a good development for our democracy.
Okay.
I think so far we've not really had about, we had some little skirmishes here and there,
okay,
but it has not really derailed those results that we had from the primaries. And well, to my own understanding, I think the level by which the parties, all the parties involved in the primary, conducted themselves, I think is commendable.
Okay.
And I think we should look forward to a better governance if these people eventually go to the governorship election.
Mm-hmm.
In regards to the outcome of the results from APC, they use the direct primaries.
Maybe when you want to come back to the
full discussion.
Fully discuss.
Okay, so by and large, I think for now, the two serious parties are APC and PDP. And I think the people of Osun State has their choice at the end of the day.
And then it'll be better. We should not underrate other parties as well.
Well, that's true.
Okay.
But we shall see.
Okay, let me go to Comrade Akin and the Yemimo. Briefly, please, your opening remarks.
I'm happy once again to be here. I want to appreciate Father for this opportunity. Now, in brief, my perspective to the post-election, the gubernatorial election of Osun State is very simple, in the sense that the election of Osun State is going to be a very easy one.
Very easy?
Yes.
You think so?
Yes, because the primary determines what happened in the major election.
Okay.
Compared to the immediate past the election of Ekiti State, the primary has issues. E.g., the primary of APC, you know that the first one was destabilized, so it was another one was later conducted that brought out the elected government. So unlike this, it was the first time in the history of political parties in Nigeria that the people were given the opportunity to exercise their right. So far you are a member, I'm talking for APC, but what has happened? We can see that both APC, PDP, which unarguably are the major parties that will be contesting for the election, the primary was very smooth.
Okay.
Without
can I please stop you right there, because we're still coming back to full discussions. Because I don't want to leave out my chairman here. Comrade Samuel Olusola Arogunleyo, opening remarks, briefly, sir.
Once again, good evening. If you are in Nigeria, good evening. Good evening. On that side, maybe good morning, maybe good afternoon.
Yes.
So, okay, this is part of the world. Good evening. This topic is very, very important because without primary, we cannot select person that we voted for, that we carry the flag of the party. And we are happy that of APC have been done. A winner has emerged to carry the flag of the APC, also PDP, also the person that will carry the flag.
That's also a match.
That's also a match. But the only confusion here is that of SDP.
Yes.
Then they have a
two
parallel something. I think that party, I'm very sorry to say that they started with confusion. I pray that they will end up in confusion. Because it is very, very important for party to agree instead of having parallel, primary. With this, I think they have to sit down and do something urgently before 23rd, which is tomorrow.
Yes.
I think I don't know whether that will be possible. But today is 22. Tomorrow is 23.
With God, everything is possible. Let's just hang it in.
Yes, they may do it overnight.
Okay, my comrade, thank you very much. We would like to go on a quick commercial break. And when we come back from the break, we will now go into full discussions of the topic, first leg of it. We'll be right back.
Ifakoyinjaye Television.
Ifakoyinjaye TV. Keep watching, guys.
Bangba la shanta awoki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
Ifakoyinjaye Television. Keep watching.
Ema wo. Ifakoyinjaye Television. Make sure you watch. Emma wo. Ifakoyinjaye Television. Make sure. Oh, you come back. Make sure. Oh, kolo lo ni bo mi just the rosary www.ifakoyinjaye.television.com. Thank you.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for Ifakoyinjaye Television Blitz. Click the red button to subscribe. And you can also connect with us on any of our social media, website www.ifakoyinjaye.tv.com, Twitter at Ifakoyinjaye TV, Facebook Ifakoyinjaye TV Lagos, Instagram Ifakoyinjaye TV, email address ifakoyinjaye@gmail.com. My name is Mustafa Damlala and I endorse Ifakoyinjaye Television. Ifakoyinjaye Television, the pride of
Ifakoyinjaye Television. Ifakoyinjaye Television. Bangba la shanta awoki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
Viewers at home, yes, grew your eyes to no other station except Ifakoyinjaye Television. That is what everybody watch now. Don't touch the dial. Ifakoyinjaye TV at www.ifakoyinjayetv.com.
Yeah, welcome back. We are still watching politics and perspectives on Ifakoyinjaye Television. And I still have my panelists seated. They are here and they are ready to discuss the topic. And the topic is post-Osun Nigeria primaries, a tale of options and its impacts. Before I allow my panelists to discuss this topic further, let me just give you a few breakdowns. PDP used delegate system to select their candidates, in which case 3,439 delegates picked PDP candidates as follows. Adeleke got 1,569 and Ogunbiyi got 1,562, which is a difference of 7 delegate votes. Akinbade Ahadi from Igbo to many people's disappointment, he scored just 56. Because a lot of people were rating him so high that probably would be the parties candidate. He scored 56. Okay, scored 3. But in contrast, APC used direct system, direct, like you said before, and in addition to that, this direct system involved option A4, whereby the party leader can carry member queue behind their candidate or the representative of their candidates at different wards, etc. And the winner was Oyetola, that is Ishaka, Alhaji Ishaka, Oyetola. He scored 127,017. Oyetola scored 127,017 votes. And the deputy speaker of the House of Representatives, Lasun, that is Yusuf Lasun, scored 21,975. While Nordin Salam, Nordin Salam is the current speaker of the Asaw Assembly of the state of Osun. He scored 17,958. And I need to mention something. I think I mentioned it, that Alhaji Oladeoju, who also contested but lost under APC, the rumor, the reports we are getting, although not yet confirmed, is that he has moved on to ADP. So I want to break this topic into two. Let's break it into two. The first aspect is what I want us to discuss on first. And what is the first aspect? Tale of options. What are the options and by which parties? How do you see those options and the relevant parties? I want to start with Comrade Samuel Oloshola Arowolo.
Well, looking at the analysis or the breakdown of the results, you can deduce from these results that the option that is available is for the party, more especially the APC, to work on the strengths of the voters. That is, you know, they use direct vote. Whereby all card carrying members of APC are eligible to vote. So the option now is that they should work on that, and the impact is, if they can harness that figure or performance, if they can harness that performance, they can use it to impact on the election coming for the person that is carrying the party flag. Also, in the PDP, the option has clearly shown already two candidates there, they were running neck to neck. Yes. Than the other people who scored near zero votes, because all that scored is 6 or
what? 36.
36. That is near zero votes. So the option now.
Sorry, 56.
16. 56. The option, both for the APC and PDP, the option now is to annex. And the aggrieved member should be worked upon to accept results. So the impact can be felt during the gubernatorial election.
Okay, let me go to Comrade Chunji Onolapo.
Okay, thank you very much. The outcome of the election. Thank you very much. The outcome of the election has really shown us what we should be expecting at the outcome of the general election, the gubernatorial elections. Why I say this is this. You see, people are in the new trend of things. Because this, I think we're in the Fourth Republic.
Yeah, this is the
Fourth Republic. And we have been using the delegate system of getting our
candidates.
But this is a new trend from the new chairman and the National Working Committee of APC. And it has been tested in Ekiti, and we can see the mammoth crowd that came out to cast their vote. Though we still need to do some, amendments to get the best out of it.
Okay.
But undermining that, the outcome shows the will of the party members. And that's why we see less rancor at the end of the result. And now, you see, when you can announce your members, you know the areas where you have large members of the party. You can easily announce those areas compared to where you have lesser people that come out to cast their votes. So now, in summary, I think APC is a state that has been governed by, Osun State has been a state that has been governed for the past 8 straight years by Rauf Arekoshola. And the picture that we that outside Osun had was that I think the governor was not directly involved in whatever political gym that might be going on. We don't see there that clearly compared to what we have in Osun, what you have in Ekiti State. At least the governor removed his hand, though he might have his candidate. No, he might.
Because the person that emerged as the chairman is
sure. But majority of those people that contested the election has one direct links with the governor of the state. You have the speaker, which is a very close ally of the governor. I think now, when the people, the party members, have come up to say this is who we really wanted, and the next day, the PDP2 came up with our own candidate, though with a close margin that I might tell that maybe there are some things that happened. Why we have those close margin? Seven different in number.
Mm-hmm.
I think now we should be expecting a peaceful governorship election.
Comrade Akin and
thank you once again. At the election, my own side of the my perspective is that the election is going to be a tight election.
Okay.
In the sense that the two major parties, it is clear to everybody that there are just two major parties that are going to contest in the election, which are the APC and the PDP. Now, the reason why I said it's going to be tight is because if you look at the two individuals that are contesting from each of the party, the party have sat down to look at the best option, and that election, that primary election, produced their best option. For the APC, their best option for now is Alhaji Gboyega Isiaka, and for the PDP, their best option is Senator
Adeleke.
Now the question is,
a lot of people argue that with you that their best option is Urumbiyi, because Urumbiyi has more integrity than Adeleke.
But in this area, it is not like we can see what happened.
And you know one thing important you need to note is that both Urumbiyi and Adeleke are from the West Senatorial District of Osun.
Okay, and but without, apart from that, we need to also look at this. Adeleke recently won the senatorial election and for a surprise, he, between APC and PDP, he came out successful. Now the question is, they looked at somebody that can win a ruling party should be able to pull the same weight in the gubernatorial election. Now, to round up, it's going to be a very tight election. The result is going to be very close because of the fact that the power of incumbency will work for APC. Yes. And the fact that this person is a known person to the people of Ekiti State, Osun State, is the president chief of staff.
So much interested, all of you interested.
It is recent. It's still fresh in our brain. Very fresh. Likewise, the PDP is known. The family, Adenike family, is a well-known family in Ekiti, in Osun State.
And wealthy family for that.
So that is a very good option. So they will use the popularity of the family. They would also rely on the wealth.
Okay.
And Adenike, as you used to see, can spring up a surprise. Just like the senatorial election held in the state.
Okay, but you see, I agree with you that the election might be tight. Let me use that word, might be tight. But I want to bring to your understanding that you can't compare senatorial election to gubernatorial. Gubernatorial is statewide, that is one. Then two, what happened then was because there was crisis within APC, and a lot of people in APC worked against the party for PDP. And I don't think they would allow that to happen.
My uncle, if you want to revisit what happened in the kitchen, that problem
is very deep, sir. Very previous, sir.
Very previous. Want to revisit what happened in Egypt. You know, I was reading some of the things sent to me by somebody. Look at the downfall of Fayose. Now, it's also in Osun. There are a lot of things against Erekosola, like inability to pay salaries.
He has been paying half salary
for almost 18 months. Up to now, he has been paying half salary. And these people, they are civil servant state. They are not anyone. So that particular thing, submission by Comrade
Akim,
that PDP may spend for price, it may be possible.
Okay. Will it be possible? Or it will not be possible. We will see. But before we go on this commercial break, let me quickly mention something. SDP, you know, I told you they have two parallel primaries. One of the primaries that, brought Yola Oshiri also adopted a direct primaries.
Okay.
So they also used option A for
the primary that brought
Oshiri. Whereas the other parallel primary used delegates. So we'll come back to discussions, but let's quickly go for a commercial break.